How to love, how to love. Got cold, I don't know. I'm my friends. Turn a fold, I don't know. 40 in. So I go. What you six?
Yeah.
Better know it. Times change. People change.
They gon' change.
They gon' love you, then they hate you. Yeah, it's strange.
Yeah, that's right.
Sell you out. For some change.
Yeah.
They go crazy for that money, they don't range.
Hey.
Lord forgive them, cause they know now what they do.
They do.
Messing with a prince, they ain't even got a clue.
They don't.
Blind them with the light when they see me coming through. And I ain't a couldn't trust me, tell them this ain't nothing new.
This ain't nothing new.
Watch your back,
better watch.
Watch your back,
better watch.
Keep the circle tight, dog, never slack.
Never loose.
Do your friends,
do you know?
Got your back. I know the ones around me, yeah, I'm keeping track.
How to love.
Got cold,
I don't know.
I'm my friends.
Turn a fold,
I don't know.
40 in.
So I go.
What you six?
Yeah.
Better know it.
How to love.
Got cold,
I don't know.
I'm my friends.
Turn a fold,
I don't know.
40 in.
So I go.
What you six?
Yeah.
Better know.
Yeah.
Never take a word. Show me how you getting down.
Yeah.
Is you with it when a man up?
Am I allowed to give alms to my parents, which are in the world? All right. Am I allowed to give alms to my parents who are in the world? Let's touch that alm part first. All right. Let's go to Sirach chapter 29 and verse 9. We also have it in Acts chapter 4 as well.
Yes, sir.
So they could see where the alms was going and what alms were actually are. Read verse 9.
Sirach chapter 29 and verse 9.
Uh-huh.
Help the poor for the commandment's sake.
So we already know when you're helping the poor are those that's keeping the commandments of God. It's not talking about when you get off of I-95 and you see the brother holding that sign. It's not talking about that, brother. Read.
And turn him not away because of his poverty.
Uh-huh. So it's that brother that is in Christ, that sister that is in Christ. Read.
Lose thy money for thy brother and thy friend.
Uh-huh.
And let it not rust under a stone to be lost.
Read.
Lay up thy treasures according to the commandments of the Most High.
Uh-huh.
And it shall bring thee more profit than gold.
Read.
Shut up alms in thy storehouses, and it shall deliver thee from all affliction.
So helping your brother, helping your sister is a way to give alms, which is going to be stored up in the kingdom of heaven. It's letting you know, store those up in the kingdom of heaven by helping your brothers and sisters and on earth. So watch this, finish it off.
It shall fight for thee against thine enemies better than a mighty shield or a strong spear.
So the alms go into you helping your brother and sisters in the Lord. Now, that's going into the alms. Now, if it's okay to give your parents money, go to Sirach chapter 12 and read verse 1. Sirach chapter 12 and read verse 1. And then we're going to get the precept for the parents. Sirach chapter 12 and verse 1.
Remember,
the parents are in the world. Read.
When thou wilt do good, know to whom thou doest it.
That right there is letting you know. If you know your mother is a crackhead, would you keep giving her $20 when she says her light bill is due?
Right.
Nah, because you know what she's going to spend that money on. But if you know your mother and you know she's a stand-up woman, she doesn't agree with the truth of what we teach, but you know she's not going to go spend that money on crack. She wants to pay her light bill, and you're her child. Yes, you can help your mother. It says, know to whom thou doest it. Read it again from the top.
Sirach chapter 12 and verse 1. When thou would do good, know to whom thou doest it.
Uh-huh. So now God is going to give you the people who you should do it to. Read.
So shalt thou be thanked for thy benefits.
Uh-huh.
Do good to the godly man.
He says that's the first priority. It meaning if your brother is hurt and you know his situation compared to your brother in the world, God says help the godly man first. Read.
Do good to the godly man,
uh-huh,
and thou shalt find a recompense.
Uh-huh.
And if not from him, yet from the Most High.
That's when you help a godly man, you'll get a payback, if not from him, but from God. God ain't going to give you a payback for you helping a sinner. Read.
There can no good come to him that is always occupied in evil. evil.
Read.
Nor to him that giveth no alms.
Read.
Give to the godly man and help not a sinner.
He says help not a sinner. But in the verse all the way up top, it tells you, know to whom thou doest it. Because watch this. Go to Sirach chapter 3 and verse 7. This is going to touch the parents.
Sirach chapter 3 and verse 7.
Read.
He that feareth the Lord will honor his father and will do service unto his parents as to his masters.
So if you honor your mother and father, of course you're going to keep God's commandments. That's the only way you could pay him back. But it says you will do them service. What type of service? Jump down to verse 12.
Verse 12, my son, help thy father in his age.
We know this government don't give a damn about our people. And your father in his old age, your mother in her old age, she barely could take care of herself. God is letting you know you're responsible for your parents. When they get old, according to the law, you have to take care of them. You have to make sure they're straight. Read.
My son, help thy father in his age, and grieve him not as long as he liveth.
Read.
And if his understanding fail, have patience with him.
We're supposed to have patience with our parents. As long as we're there, we can still shine that light to where they could repent. Some brothers know it took years, months for them parents to come in, but they came in. But it was because of those righteous examples always being there for them. Read.
And despise him not when thou art in thy full strength.
So it says you're up on your feet, you're able to do things, you're able to make extra bread, and your mother and father, the ones that raised you, are down and out. They're in their old age, they can't take care of themselves, and they ask you, look, I need $25, $50 to pay my light bill. Your answer, it shouldn't be no, let me go seek counsel. Like, yo, they the ones who put the change your diaper from 1 year old to 3 years old.
Hey, it says that in Sirach 7:27-28.
The book of Sirach, chapter 7 and verse 27.
Read.
Honor thy father with thy whole heart, and forget not the sorrows of thy mother.
You brothers, especially you brothers that was raised in a single parent household with your mother, you know the struggles they've been through.
Well, that you know, put them through.
Right. You know the sorrows that they go through. But for the father as well, he has to work sun up, sun down. And he do have barely time to spend time with him. But yet he always makes sure that there's lights in the house, there's food on the table, and he don't ask you to thank him. You don't never say, hey, did you thank me for the food? He say, thank God for it. Read.
Verse 28, remember that thou was begotten of them.
It says, remember, they're the ones who, after they born you, well, God, you know, put you in the womb, fashioned you. But after you was born, they made sure you was good. They took care of you. Your mother pushed you out. Read.
And how canst thou recompense them the things that they have done for thee?
There's no way you could pay your parents back. But what you can at least do for them, read.
Fear the Lord with all thy soul, and reverence his priest.
Keep his commandments. And God says to take care of your parents. Just know to whom thou doest it to. Make sure they ain't on no drugs or things like that. That's it.
So, officer, the Bible does not tell us to put away our family. Because recently I just heard somebody say, when you become a part of IUIC, you got to put away your whole family and don't do nothing for them. Just kick them to the curb. Well, the Bible tells us to do things for them. And in their old age, take care of them.
This is the barometer. Go ahead. The barometer of doing and not doing and all those things is righteousness versus wickedness. That's
all
it.
Praises.
That's right. And that's what those out there, the lonely nights, the individualites out there in the world are trying to deceive the other people. They're not giving them that piece of information.
Right.
They don't give them that. So they gotta, you know, do away with them, cut them off, all of that. You can't even, no. We just say don't keep Christmas with them.
Right.
Cut them off when it comes to Christmas, Thanksgiving. Don't pick up the phone when it comes to that.
Right.
But they don't give them that part of it, so they can paint you in an evil light.
Right.
That you are in a cult because you don't want to keep Christmas with your mama.
Right. Right. Watch this, because rightly dividing the word of truth, Matthew chapter 5 and verse 14. Matthew chapter 5 and verse 14 with that old separate, I don't want to see you no more. That's not according to the word of God. Yeah, he's going to divide us. He's going to show us, I don't do, we at variance. I don't believe in that.
Hey, Christ said he's going to do the separating.
Right.
It is naturally going to happen that you'll spend less and less time with your family and talk to them less, because the more the Spirit of God fills you up, the less you can be around wickedness.
Right.
That's coming from Christ. If we didn't say it at all, it would naturally happen.
Right.
We just have to put it into your remembrance, because that's our job as teachers to do.
Bring it up. Read that.
The book of Matthew, chapter 5 and verse 14. Ye are the light of the world. A city that is set on a hill cannot be hid.
We know the light is the laws of God, according to Proverbs chapter 6, verse 23. Read.
Neither do men light a candle and put it under a bushel, but on a candlestick, and give it light unto all that are in the house.
What does a house consist of? Brothers, raise your hand. What does a house consist of? I'm not talking about the roof, the doors, and the windows, and the TVs, brothers. Isaac.
It's showing leadership. People, family members.
We're just talking about it. Because family members, say it. Plain.
Mother, father.
There you go. Mothers, fathers, brothers, sisters. If everybody in the house was keeping commandments, why do that person need to be a light in the house? The whole house is supposed to be lit up. So it's letting you know, if you are keeping God's commandments, you are a light in a house that has darkness inside of it. Letting you know, you gotta let your light shine amongst your brothers and sisters. Meaning there's gonna be times where you're around them, and you're supposed to let your light shine. So it's not at all times you're going to be separate from them. There's going to be times where you're together with them, and you're showing them this is the example by these commandments.
Go to Luke 16 and 9. Show you what Christ said about giving of your money.
The book of Luke, chapter 16 and verse 9. And I say unto you, make to yourselves friends of the mammon of unrighteousness.
Mammon of unrighteousness. Mammon means money. Make to yourself the friends of mammon of unrighteousness. Those that don't keep the commandments. Have a certain type of relationship with them, is what he's saying. Go ahead.
That when ye fail, they may receive you into everlasting habitations.
So you might fall, and you might need that $20 for some gas to go to the Sabbath. Oh, damn. But if you've been the devil in the house the whole time, now get there yourself. It takes a while to get to that level to understand how to maneuver amongst the wicked. Because all of us up here, as soon as we found out everybody around us was the devil, either you repent or you die. Don't say nothing to me. I ain't pick it up. We all did that. It takes some time to be able to learn how to maneuver amongst the unrighteous, giving and taking, to be able to keep that balance of some sort of peace between you and the ungodly. But Christ is telling you, make friends with those that got some money in the world. So if you fall on hard times, they can help you out too. Okay, so ain't nothing wrong with exchanging funds back and forth. Just be wise of why you giving it. Because, like you said, they might be on drugs. Hate to be feeding them a habit just to be saying, I'm giving them money because they my parents and they push me into the world. But you know, every time that you give them some money, you come back, you see them with a six-pack tucked on the side up under the chair when they're on the front porch, and they got the drink in the brown paper bag all the way up to the top with just the mouth of it open. They don't want you to see what they got in the bag. It'd be one of them 211s.
It's 8 o'clock in the morning. They already...
Yeah, already slurred language. I ain't doing nothing. I'm just out here thinking. Oh, you pull up. They see you pull up. This is what they do. This is how you know they something in that bag ain't supposed to be. They pull up. You pull up, and they do this. What's going on, cuz? You know you done gave them some money for something wicked, all right?
Now you see the tremendous of God. We are not black men. We are the Israelites.
Take care of us. it's so hard to serve God. And why when I say that I'm a Jew, it sound odd? For years I've been walking around saying that I'm a black man. I ain't saying that no more, it sound wrong, man.
This is Bishop Nathaniel of Israel United in Christ. Please subscribe to our YouTube channels. Stay up to date with our latest events, music, and classroom lessons. IUIC plans to continue visiting different countries where this gospel has not been preached before. IUIC needs your help in pushing this truth. So join us. Subscribe to our Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and podcast, and stay up to date with us. For more information, please visit www.israelunite.org.